quite the little explorer, aren't you? Serves me right for trying to pen you in. Come on over here. I want to show you something. See that? It was your mother's favorite passage. It's from the Bible. Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. She always loved that. All right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amata wants to play.
These experiments
don't
are
a damn fool.
The experiment to prepare. Prepare.
Surprise! Stanley, you turned the lights on too fast.
Stanley.
You blinded the poor kid.
Happy birthday!
Can you believe it? He is growing up so fast.
Happy birthday, pal. I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you. If only you...
Congratulations,
mother.
Young man. I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I? Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well... you're ready to take on your first official vault responsibilities. So here you are. As overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000. Get used to it. You'll be getting your first work assignment tomorrow.
Enjoy your party. You're only 10 once, so have fun.
Happy birthday! We really surprised you, didn't we? Your dad was afraid you were onto us. But I told him not to worry. You're so easy to fool. You're welcome. But really, your dad did most of it. Hey, I bet you can't guess what I got you for your birthday. Go on, guess. Ha! I knew I found this. Well, nice party.
Oh man, you got a pit.
Enjoying
boy.
Yourself?
I wish I was 10.
Happy birthday, Sonny.
Are you having a nice time?
Attention, everyone!
How's it going, pal?
It's time to cut the cake!
Wait!
Hey, happy birthday, Joe's Queen!
Oh no!
Allow me to... you a happy birthday. I would offer you a piece of cake, but...
How's it going, Pip?
Allow me to wish you a happy birthday.
How do you like that Pip-Boy, son? Fit all right and everything? As a matter of fact, I did. I'm glad you like it. Some may think the A-Series is a bit basic, but I've always preferred them for their reliability. Don't mention it. Oh, yes, I almost forgot. Happy birthday. Not much, but I hope you like it.
You are
but I'm not sure anyone else did.
Hey, how about those vault dwellers?
People always enjoy my little speeches.
Who wants to go around?
Are you having a nice party? 10 years old. Goodness, listen to me ramble. You're way... Such a nice, polite young man you are. Don't ever lose your gift to speaking your mind so directly. We could use more of that down here. Here you go.
Besides, that friend of yours can... I hope you appreciate the effort Amata put into this party. She really seems to like you, for some reason. Don't presume too much on her friendship, young man. I'm still the overseer, and I'm still in charge of this vault and everyone in it.
Happy birthday!
I think you really are as dumb as you look. I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake! Give me that! Oh, yeah? Should have just given me
Butch,
the sweet.
Butch, what do you think you're doing? Leave him alone.
I know you were.
You all right, son?
The water
he didn't hurt you, did he?
Everything's fine.
I hope Butch didn't hurt you. That's fine, son. I'm glad to see you're not letting Butch bully you. He's gonna be a handful in a few years if his mother doesn't take him in hand. Well, no harm done then.
Are you all right? Is Butch giving you a hug? I'm glad to hear it. Once you start letting bullies push you around, you'll never see the end of it. Come on now. I bet there's someone else out there with a present for you.
You were nothing to worry about. Me and Andy got her all picked up again last night. Good as
new. Yeah, I got one.
The Mackers.
Janice?
Hey, Doc.
Jeez,
I'm
glad
you're
gang. You or me?
Nice.
Thanks. I'll send him right down. Hey, that was Jonas on the intercom. He and I have been cooking up a little surprise. Jonas is waiting.
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday, dearie. My goodness. They sure did. My, my. 10 years old. And now look at you. A great... Since this was such a... Of course. Run along now, dearie.
What are you doing down here, young man? I thought... Hey, relax. Listen, now that you're 10, you don't have to take guff like that from grown-ups anymore. Got it? Hold on one more minute. I think your dad will want to give you...
Are you ready for your... The Overseer gave you your Pip-Boy, and you're old enough to do some work. Your own BB gun. It's a little old, but it should work perfectly. Jonas found it down here. It was in pretty rough shape. Took us a... You know how tough it is to find a spring that small? Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his. So, what do you think? Want to give it a try? Easy now. It's only a BB gun, but it's not a toy. Let's go try it out. Jonas and I have found a nice spot for you. Well, what do you think? You can come down here and shoot anytime you want. Couldn't have done it without Jonas's...
Happy birthday, buddy. Hey, you don't turn 10 every day.
Careful, it's a rad roach. Think you can take care of that with your BB gun? Just aim and shoot. You'll be fine. Good work. That's one less rad roach to deal with. Let's get a picture together. Hey, Jonas, get a picture of me with a big game hunter.
Smile!
Boys and girls, different parts.
What is your problem anyway? So, I'm the Overseer's daughter, so what? Like, I get any kind of special treatment.
Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega. The beginning and the end. As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old boy. So yes, you have to go to class to take your goat exam. Go on now. You've got a goat to take. Hey, you're 16 now. Come on. The generalized occupational helps to fix... You know what... That's not the way it works. And it won't do to go around asking questions like that. Especially not around the Overseer. I want to tell you something now. It's important, so listen closely. You're safe here. Because what's up there, on the outside, that's not the life I want for you. And it's not... That's what the Overseer... He's not about to let any... You're here now. Take care, son.
Good morning. Stopped in to see the old man before class, eh? Hey, 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 sport. It's been a while
morning,
since
Jonas.
You stopped in here to... Morning, Doc. How's things?
Have you had a chance to look over these results?
I was just going over them. Something you're worried about?
I'd just like to keep an eye on it.
No problem. I'll have my report ready this afternoon.
Sounds good.
I'm a little worried. I hope Jonas can take a look at me soon.
Get out of my way, you stupid tunnel snakes!
I can show you a real tunnel snake, Amata.
God, Butch! Why don't you just leave me alone?
What are you gonna do, Amata? Go run and tell your daddy, Anna? Look, I'm not looking to rumble with you. Only the baddest gang in Vault 101. Like you don't know. We rule this vault, and what we say goes. You'll stay out of our way if you... None of your business, kid. Get out of here before you get hurt. If you mess with the tunnel snakes, you're asking for it. Got me? Like I'm gonna listen to a little... Whoa! Take it easy. No need to go all psycho on me again. We were just joking with her. Come on, tunnel snakes. This little bitch isn't worth our time. Whatever you say, Butch. You're the boss. Tunnel snakes rule.
Fine. Let's go.
Thanks for getting rid of them. I don't know why they won't leave me alone. Just because my father is the overseer, I guess? Idiots.
Yes, I think I'd like that.
Well, you made it. All set for the goat? Trust me. Listen, I like your dad. I might even like you if I wasn't. So here's what I'm going to do. If you want to skip the test, just tell me how you want it to come. Well...
A smart mouth? This is serious! My father's men are looking for you. They've already killed... You don't understand. It's your dad. He's left the vault. And they think you're part of it. You know how... You can worry about revenge later. Right now, you've got to get away before... That's Listen, there's a secret tunnel that leads directly from my father's office. Use these to get into his office. That's how I always get in. We don't have time for this! Maybe this pistol I stole from my father will make... Okay, I'll try... I'll meet you at the vault door if I can, but don't...
more roaches! Take that, you little buggers!
Get it off me!
Blood! Ah! Hiyah! Blood! Ah! There he is! You shouldn't have tried to run! Yeah! Ow! Ah! Blood! Betrayed us all! No!
You gotta help me! My mom's trapped in there with the... No, I can't go back in there. It's...
Oh my God! Someone help me! Get them away from me! Oh, please, help me! Get them away from me!
My mom! Hey!
Severely. That is all.
Where did those things come from? Oh, I need another drink.
Oh, you're lucky it was me who found you. The others won't be so forgiving. I don't know what you're up to, and I don't want to know. Just clear out of here, and I'll pretend I never saw you. It's a real shame it's come to this. I can't believe what they did to Jonas. Officer Mack was just out of control. But you're a good kid. You didn't do anything to deserve this.
Young sir, how very good to see you again. I do.
Me and Andy were in a tight spot there. Ain't no mistake. Good thing he loves toasting roaches so much. Why don't you look where you're going?
He's gone topside for a spot. Sure. Could be back any moment, I bet.
We should just go back to our quarters.
It's our only chance, don't you see? We're getting out of here, just like the doctor. I'm not gonna let anyone stop us.
Tom!
It's me!
Be careful!
Tom Holden! Just let me through! This isn't going to be quick.
Any resident found outside his or her quarters...
You! This is your fault. You and your stupid father. He had to go and leave, didn't he?
Ouch.
He had to mess things up for everybody. Guards, he's over here.
up sooner or later.
Amata.
Should have tried to run. Don't.
Just tell us where to find your friend so we can talk to him.
He's my friend.
Look, it's the Doc's kid. Your father betrayed us all. Come out, Jin. Stop in the name of the others here. Shouldn't have tried to run. Look where you're going.
Any resident found outside his or her quarters will be dealt with severely. That's his fault.
boss!
I hope you're here to turn yourself in, young man. You're already in enough trouble as it is. Don't make it worse for yourself. Oh, is that all? Is there anything else I can get you while you're here? You'll get nothing from me. My God, you're a cold-blooded little shit, aren't you? I think you'd actually do it. Here, leave the vault. I'll have you shot on sight if you ever come back.
Hold on, Jonas. I need to record this first. I don't really know how to tell you this. I hope you'll understand, but I know you might be angry. I thought about it for a long time, but in the end, I decided it was best for you not to know. So many things could have gone wrong, and there's really no telling how the Overseer will react when he finds out. It's best if he can blame everything on me. Obviously, you already know that I'm gone. It was something I needed to do. You're an adult now. You're ready to be on your own. Maybe someday things will change and we can see each other again. I can't tell you why I left or where I'm going. I don't want you to follow me. God knows life in the vault isn't perfect, but at least you'll be safe. Just knowing that will be enough to keep me going.
Don't mean to rush you, Doc, but I'd feel better if we got this over with.
Okay. Go ahead. Goodbye. I love you.
You. I told you my father wasn't himself. I don't know what he might have done if you hadn't come along. You'd better get out of here. I'll try to meet. it! You opened the door! My God, I almost didn't believe it. No, you didn't need me. If anyone can survive out there, it's tempting, but my place is here. The vault needs me more than you do. I'm the only one who has a chance to talk some sense into my father. Listen, if you do catch up with your dad, tell him I'm sorry for you know, Jonas and my father and everything. Goodbye.
Stark, in the name of the Overseer. You shouldn't have tried to run. Going out there. I don't care what the Overseer says.
Thank you.
Who the hell are you? Where'd you come from? Did Moriarty send you? Colin Moriarty, the owner of Moriarty's Saloon in Megaton. That sack of shit is convinced that I'm some crazy junkie who stole money from him. Look, I used to work for that slob, doing, you know, favors for guys. Well, I got sick and tired of it. I told Moriarty I'm taking my share of the caps and leaving. I even slept with the pig to seal the deal. Next morning, he tells me I couldn't leave. So I bolted. I took my money and ran. Now he's branded me a thief and a junkie and sent his cronies to find me. I guess I need a new hiding place. You'd do that for me? I can't believe it. You hardly even know me. Thanks, kid.
You can't just take that. Belong to you? Cut it out, will you? Where? What? Come on.
had everything they wanted. Power, wealth, prestige. And it made them lazy, America. Oh, yes, and laziness breeds stupidity. Rest assured, I will not make the mistakes of my predecessors. When John Henry Eaton builds a country, he builds it to last. The American way. But you, my darling America, deserve that. Don't you deserve a future free?
apart. It's done. Screw this.
Yeah! to the little boy playing tough guy.
Dead meat sack!
Hiding from me? You better hope I don't find you. Scared, just like a little bitch.
first mistake.
Thank you.
What do you need? Bye.
Keep it on the level, and everything will be fine.
I'll be there. Another newcomer. Name's Lucas Sims, town sheriff, and mayor too, when the need arises. So that's the way it's gonna be, huh? That's fine. Just as long as we understand each other. This here is my town. These are my people. You so much as breathe wrong, and I'm gonna fucking end ya. God, I hope you ain't one of those psychotic quiet types. So, is there anything else I can do for you? Nope, sorry. I got enough fires to put out in this place that I don't... It's called the... To the south... Mind your...
Yes?
Look at this! New blood! Tell me, boy, you ever hear of the Enclave? The last remnant of the good old USA they are. Now, I don't know you from Adam, but I got you pegged for a patriot, and any patriot worth his salt is gonna toss his gun in for the Enclave. Any day now, they're gonna roll up here, and then this nightmare will be over for good. But listen to me, Ramble. I'm... Could be the guy I... Why? Why? Look around you! This is the good old USA. Sure, she looks a little bit different these days, but you're still on American soil. And even if you were born in some underground vault, you were born under the United States, which makes you an American. And it's your duty and my duty to support our country and our president, no matter what. Understand? Why, that's unthinkable. Where in the Constitution does it say that we're supposed to run around questioning the government, huh? Well, when you put it that way, wait. You're just trying to confuse me with your fancy vault education and your textbooks. I'll have none of it. Did you have something else you wanted to ask, or were you... They're on the radio. They have been for years. President Eden talks about everything they're doing. They got flying robots all around, watching everything so they know what to do when they finally swoop in and clean this place up. You'll see. People think they're the
Help me.
Good to see you.
Hey.
Yeah, what is it? Well, it's no I spend. Now, I don't expect much from strangers, but if you. I hope you.
This ancient weapon of war is our salvation. It is the very symbol of Atom's glory. Let it serve as a reminder of the division that has occurred in the past, and the resplendence of the promise of our division in the times to come. Give your bodies to Atom, my friends. Release yourself to his power, feel his glow, and be divided. There shall be no tears, no sorrows, no suffering. For in the division, we shall see our release from the pain and heartache of this world.
Every day is the same damn thing.
I told you, Gob, it ain't the raid.
Who do we have here? My, my. Just when I had all but given up hope. My dear boy, I'm very happy to make your acquaintance. I am Mr. Burke. And you, well, you are not a regular. resident of this putrescent cesspool and makes you a rather valuable individual. Finally, someone with a modicum of civility and common sense. I represent certain interests, and those interests view this town, this megaton, as a blight on a burgeoning urban landscape. You have no connections here, no interest in this cesspool's affairs or fate. You could assist us in erasing this little accident off the map. The undetonated atomic bomb for which this town is named is still very. I have in my possession a fusion. You'll rig it to the bomb. Is that the best you can do? Oh.
Radio.
Hey.
The Enclave station comes in fine.
Traveler, eh?
It's Galaxy News. Their signal.
Come on, you piece of junk.
Yes?
Every day it's the same damn thing.
I told you, Gob, it ain't the radio. The Enclave station comes in fine. It's Galaxy News. Their signal's been shit lately.
Who do we have here? Is that the best you can do? I'm a...
Why?
Who do we have here? Well played. An extra 500 caps, in addition to the... When it's done, meet me at... Absolutely not. The plate... Lack the aptitude, you mean? You're not rewiring the thing, just attaching the pulse charge to the detonator. If you get stumped, talk to Leo Stahl. He might have something to help you concentrate.
Work. Work. Come on,
traveler,
work.
Eh?
Come on. Goddamn radio.
Just give it up, Gob. You're not going to get anything.
I don't recognize you. I do. Great. I'd like you to deliver this message to my family in the Arafu settlement. I haven't heard from them in months, and I'm worried. As soon as you get there, talk to Davis West. He'll be glad to pay you for... Sure. Be glad to, since you're doing... Arafu... Hey...
Hey, Smoothskin. Do you need... Wait. You're not gonna hit me? Yell at me? Not even berate me a little bit? Well now, that's a surprise. I'm used to every asshole smooth skin in this town giving me shit just because I look like a corpse. I'm glad to see that there are a few worthwhile people around here. Listen, Moriarty'd have my head if he caught me selling at a discount. But for you, I'll risk it. Oh yeah, I do remember a guy like that. Honestly, I usually keep my head down. I tend to get smacked around. Sorry, Smoothskin. I can't take the risk. Moriarty...
Hell of a day, isn't it? Hoo-wee! Look at you! Now, I haven't seen one of those vault jumpsuits. Name's Billy Creel. You call me Billy, all right? I know Megaton looks more like a boneyard than a town. Take me and Maggie, for instance. We make do just fine. I trade the stuff I scavenge, and she helps keep me on the straight and narrow. Oh, sorry. I guess I got ahead of myself, huh? Maggie's 9. Sweetest little girl you'd ever care to meet. I ain't never had a daughter, but if I did, I'd want her to be Maggie. I took her in when her parents got killed by raiders. It was a pretty bad scene. Small settlement up north. I'd stopped in to trade some salvage. I found Maggie hiding under a bed in the same room where her parents had been butchered. We've been together ever since. Me? I deal with the caravan suppliers. But more importantly, I take care of Maggie. Of course, she's getting a little old to have Billy looking over.
Got something on your mind? Hi there. I'm Nova. New to Megaton, huh? Do yourself a favor and keep walking. Some of us stay for a few days, and then it's... Yeah, I remember that man. I saw him talking to Moriarty. It's hard to forget handsome men like that. I'd love to spend time with you, too. Look, I can help you. Get into the back office of this place. Moriarty keeps a terminal there. Everything you want is inside the terminal. Here's the password to it. Too bad you're so young, kid. I could teach you some stuff you'd never forget. Who, Gob? Well, if you can get back... He don't talk about it much, but apparently there's a whole city of ghouls somewhere. He's mentioned his mother a couple of times. But he's been here for, I guess about 15 years now. Ever since... With Gob? I don't want to sound shallow or anything. I mean, I'm a whore. My standards aren't exactly high. But there are places even I won't go. Johnnies that are squishier than me are one of them. Well, the miserable bastard is hard on all of us. But Gob gets it the... Takes you renting a room. Sleep in it or don't. Huh? Oh, you mean why was Gob banging on that radio? There's the Enclave station. I don't know who they are, but I think it might... And there's Galaxy News Radio. It's run by... It's the only... He keeps talking...
Gob?
Hello.
Evening. Evening.
Looking for a drink? You've come to the right place.
Hey there.
Gob!
Yes, sir, Mr. Moriarty. What is it?
Can I do for
These
you,
Daddy-o?
These
floors are filthy, a useless fucking zombie. Next time you sweep, put your
Why
back
don't you
into
look
it.
Where you're going? Mr. Moriarty? Sir? I'm sorry. You're right, of course. It won't be a problem. I promise you.
All right, stop your pathetic sniveling and just do what. Told.
What's the matter? Never seen a ghoul before?
What's shaking?
What?
I'm not in the mood for you, asshole.
I hear you're that stray from the vault. Ugh, I haven't seen one of you for years. Good to meet you. I'm Moira Brown. I run Craterside's... Say... Great. Oh, certainly, Your Majesty. Then consider this armored vault suit to be Megaton's gift to your mighty empire. However, you may consider going incognito. People around here don't always take kindly to monarchy, you know. That'll be good for the book. In fact, want to help me with the research? I can pay you, and it'll be fun. Well, no, then they just yell a lot. All right, then. Now, I think the first chapter will have to be things like where it... Ooh, sounds like fun. Well, food and... There's an old super duper market. Well, that's what I need your help for, isn't it? So I need you to get. Really? I should be able to take care of that. Well, here's hoping you don't have. Now, let me take a few notes and I'll handle that. Okay, lie back and. Okay, a little Brahmin milk, a couple magnets, and maybe a few happy thoughts. Well, what do you know? It worked! I mean, I was pretty sure it would, obviously. Here, take a few radiation chems with I need someone... Well, food and medicine. There's an old... Landmines are one of the few... I've heard stories about a ghost town. Sounds like the place for some field work. Get in there, get...
Just here to make sure nothing goes wrong with you or her.
Yeah.
bodies to Atom, my friend.
Hey.
What's up?
You looking for the mayor or the sheriff?
Ah, fellow student on the path of the wasteland. The type of safety that... See the... So... Please... Enjoy my selection of high-quality problem solvers. A pleasure doing business with you.
Thank you.
All standard radio and television stations in the United States are off the air in the first daytime test of the Conelrad system of emergency broadcasting. This drill is being conducted in conjunction with Operation Alert of the Nationwide Civil Defense Exercise. The frequency to which you are tuned at the present time is the one on which you will normally receive civil defense information in the event of a national emergency. Remember to keep your battery radio and your standard radio in good condition, so that in case of enemy attack, you can get vital civil defense information and instructions.
Anyone who can hear me, my name is Werner. I come from a settlement to the north. I have information of great value to anyone willing to help me free my people. Please, help us. This message repeats. To anyone who can hear me, my name is Werner. I come from a settlement to the north. I have information of great value to anyone willing to help me free my people. Please, help us. This message repeats. To anyone who can hear me, my name is Werner. I come from a settlement to the north. I have information of great value to anyone willing to help me free my people. Please, help us. This message repeats.
Thank you.
is now a fire zone. A lawful use of deadly force is in.
This is basic civil defense information from the Department of Defense. There's one easy, sensible thing your family should do to prepare for a possible time of emergency. Set aside a few simple, basic supplies you'll need to take to the public fallout shelter. Supplies to help keep you and your family alive and well in event of enemy attack. For instance, any special medicines or diet foods required by members of the family, insulin, heart tablets, baby food, and other infant supplies, blankets, a battery-powered radio, a flashlight, extra batteries. And if the nearest public shelter hasn't been stocked yet with emergency rations and supplies, you'll need to take as much food and water as you can carry. Emergency supplies are needed for a private home shelter, too. Lay in enough food, canned or packaged, and preferably pre-cooked, for 2 weeks, plus enough drinking water in tightly kept containers or jars to give each person at least a quart a day or more. For help in making up a list of needed supplies, consult your local civil defense office.
Thank you.
Welcome, sir or madam, to Crazy Wolfgang's traveling junk store. The depot of detritus, the shop of slop, and the caravan of crap. Now, what odds and ends can I, the craziest of all possible Wolfgangs, offer to you? Crazy Wolfgang's got just what you need, assuming you need the random junk that I've got. Thanks. See you out on the road, huh?
wasn't expecting any visitors. My, my, my. You certainly do look a little bit worn out from your travels. Oh, just look at my terrible manners. I'm Agatha. It's so nice to meet you. Now, what brings you all the way out here? Oh, don't worry about me. I'm just fine out here. My husband, rest his poor soul, saw to it that our house was well protected from the elements and the inhabitants of the wastes. Apart from supply caravans, you're the first person to set foot inside my house in a long time. It's not for lack of trying at this point, mind you. I'm just far off the beaten path. Living in this isolation protects me, but it has also made me very lonely. Oh, goodness, no. I have a supply caravan that passes here maybe once a week. I trade with him for whatever I need, and I stock up enough till they return. Besides shelter, well, I offer something in the way of entertainment. I play songs on my homemade violin, and people trade me goods. If not in person, I use my husband's old radio set. The men in the caravan say it keeps their morale up on lonely nights in the wasteland. Oh, you are a clever one. Yes, that's exactly the problem that I have with it. It doesn't quite play all of the notes correctly, and I have to constantly tinker with it. Yes. My husband was very proud of the setup. He tinkered with that thing for years to get it working. I've tried to use it to get whatever I need, but I've never gotten a reply. Thank you. While my husband had his hobbies, I'm afraid mine was making that sorry instrument. I only wish I could replace it with something better. But now that you mention it, yes, there is. My training depends on my violin. Without it, I have nothing to play, no way to make music. If you can bring me a violin, a better one, I'd feel much more secure.
Civil defense is common sense. This is Boris Karloff.
Yes, very sad, isn't it? Sad to think that no more musical instruments will ever be made the old way ever again. Well, fortunately, I know where perhaps the last real violin in the world exists. If you give me your word that you will recover it, I will tell you more. Oh, my, I didn't know I still had the looks. Well, you just made my day, you sweet thing. Let me give you something extra to help you on your way. I have a small amount of ammunition that my husband left behind, a box of odds and ends. I don't think I've opened it in years. If you do this for me, you're welcome to take whatever you need. Oh, I don't think I've been this happy in years. As promised, here's the key to the ammunition box. It's right under the radio table. Before you leave, I have some information that may help you, at least a place to begin. It all starts with my great-great-grandmother Hilda back in 2077, before the bombs fell. Of a kind, yes. Hilda sent a good deal of letters to my great-grandmother Mary, who passed them on, and so forth. I suppose the correspondence could be considered a diary of sorts. It certainly is a long time. That precious instrument has been through a lot. Anyway, Hilda was quite a special woman, classically trained and exceptionally talented at the violin. Her pride and joy was her Stradivarius violin,
I can only imagine how exquisite this instrument must have been. When the war reared its head, she was invited by Vault Tech into Vault 92. They claimed the vault would be dedicated to preserving musical talent. Vault Tech was always promoting the vaults being used for the preservation of the arts and all that nonsense. Hilda couldn't pass on a chance to meet many of the other musical talents of the world, so... Then the bombs fell, the vault was sealed, and my family never heard... She kept it in a special pressurized case. Inside the case is the perfect temperature and humidity for the instrument. If the case is still functioning, the Stradivarius would be in perfect shape. Hilda Stradivarius was named the Soi Stradivarius. All of them had names. That's what I want you to get. That's the catch. I have no idea where. I'd suggest making your way to Vault Tech headquarters in the DC ruins. Good luck! I'm sorry. When the bomb... Watch yourself out there.
Fall out with the greatest of a plan. When your white count's getting higher, hurry, don't delay. I'll hold you close and kiss those radiation burns away. Crawl out through the fallout, baby, to my loving arms. Through the rain of strong...
Trading caps for craps.